Nikita had an interview for a senior data engineer position. It was a round with a chief architect. They started with "Tell me about yourself" question. Have a nice time watching.
First of all, thank you for having me today. My name is Nikita. I'm senior data engineer. I'm really surprised that we have interview, I think second interview with the vice president of engineering. It's really actually uncommon. I'm working right now at Netskirt and I'm leading a data engineering team. I was hired for the specific role for the Netskirt. Netskirt is a company, it's a global CDN provider. We have our physical edges that are located near the ISPs. We are helping our clients to do video streaming. Our clients are Amazon, ITV, Peacock, and many customers in Europe. I'm doing all this stuff with the metrics from our edges, from the clients, aggregating and cleansing, preparing, transforming, and giving to our analytical engineer and other internal usage for the data marts and BI tools. I was hired more than 2 years ago for the specific role to automate the data collection, transforming, checking the quality of the data, and aggregate this data from different sources. You can ask me about anything because I am I was creating these pipelines and the whole infrastructure based on the AWS and Terraform. If I would describe my tech stack, I will say that we are using DBT, Snowflake, AWS. For the ingestion, we are using Airbyte. In the beginning, I started with developing the whole infrastructure based on AWS inside the Kubernetes because I decided that I can manage more closely our infrastructure and I can scale it. That's why I decided to use DBT core in Kubernetes, Airbyte open source solution, only Snowflake and Sigma, it's like an external tool and we are paying for that. I develop the public subnets, private subnets for AWS, strict restriction to accessing for these APIs. Of course, I did not alone this infrastructure. I also just assign some of the tasks to other developers, data engineers. But anyway, we did this together because I proposed some POC, some solution. I did some documentation, describe the possibility how to choose the right tools for our requirements. I usually talking to non-technical persons, for example, accounting or marketing team, to receive the right requirements and discuss what they want to see in the end, which types of data, how often we will modify the data. I'm aggregating these requirements and give some proposal and we starting to implement this. As I understand from my previous conversation with the HR manager in your company, you are doing pretty similar, but you are in the beginning of your way. Do you want to use this data also for the machine learning and to do some prediction? Because I have some experience preparing the data for machine learning engineers with the feature table, and I'm receiving some requirements from them, like features, and creating the table for them, and they are just executing Airflow docs with some Python scripts and ML models inside, and we are writing some scores in the table. And for example, if our customers are signing in or registering on our website, they are getting some score based on the answers that they are filling in the beginning. So it's like working ML prediction to them.
You said that you prepared documentation. How did it help to make a decision?
Recently, I analyzed the market, and because it's many tools on the market for the data engineering, I usually monitoring the open source solution and paid solutions. And for example, if we are taking Airbyte and Fivetran, I know that it's a huge difference between Airbyte and Fivetran. Fivetran is taking per row. I mean, we are paying for reading per row, so it's a really huge difference, because Airbyte, we just can use it and that's it. For example, with the Snowflake and Redshift, it's also different costs and on the computing, because storing, it's almost nothing, but the compute power, it's cost a lot. And I usually write a documentation document about ingestion, maybe transformation and loading, and adding the different tools and based on the paid version or open source solution that can we implement inside the Kubernetes, and giving some highlights about this. And after that, we can decide with the management, or after that with our team, what we're gonna do, and what's the estimation time for the implementation. I think it's a normal practice for the market and for the companies, if they want to not faced with some unusual behavior, it's gonna do this way.
How do you work with stakeholders? How do you get what you need from them?
If it's unclear for me, and I started already work on the problem, I usually write some question, prepare this question before the conversation, and because each solution, it's almost similar, right? And I have some experience on my side, how we can solve this problem, and which tools do we need to use, or some data modeling problem with the star schema or dimensional tables. So I prepared it before the conversation, and when I'm getting on the conversation, I'm asking this question to clarify their requirements and also propose the possible solution. How can we overcome this? If it's non-technical stakeholders, I'm using some non-technical language and metaphors to explain my technical speech to gather these right requirements, and maybe show, or could you please show me on the graph what you want to see in the end. If it's score or a line chart or pie chart or something, like, I don't know. What do you mean? What do you want in the end? Because it's simpler if we are going from the end to the beginning, and I can clarify each step. And also, it's really cool when we start to also working with the Open Metadata Framework to unite all the sources and the tables, because it's really handful to find the right source or tables and find the actual data where it is, because sometimes it's a really huge amount of data and inside the different tables, and we can easily search throughout it, and also our clients or internal clients can use these.
What are your sources for information about data tools?
So actually, I can open my recent research. I have this on GitHub. Actually, sources, I'm using official websites, of course. Mm-hmm. I know source solution of what's the paid solution. Recently, I created a table, for example, here. It's type, open source, paid solution, open or black box, supporting of the community, which protocols they have, open protocols or proprietary protocols, about the support. If we need the support on a paid version, for example, we can get it. If not, it could be open source solution and support is our community. And the costs, how cheap is it? How can easily we implement it? Do we have the supporting of containerization using inside the Docker or not? And I also specify by categories. For example, here I used storage consideration. I include Redshift, Athena, Amazon EMR, Serverless, Databricks, BigQuery, Snowflake, and Trina for the storage. For the processing layer, I used Airbyte, Meltana, Fivetran, and Stitch, and I just created highlights for each of them. For the integration, I use DBT. Actually, it's my favorite, and I don't have any another solution to that. But I also specify Matillion here and PySpark in case of Databricks. Right. For the orchestration, I used Airflow. Actually, also I really adore about the Airflow and the orchestration using different operators. It could be basic operator, Python, mm-hmm. Kubernetes operator, or just a simple. It's really good to we can launch any Python script inside Airflow and use the right order for our data pipelines execution. Orchestration, what else here? Astronomer, Databricks, Dagster, Prefect, AWS Glue. This is the huge steps, but I highlight this, prepare this data so I know what's the difference, and I can explain for the management what's the possible solution we can use.
What is your workday split between implementation, documentation, and requirements gathering?
I can definitely say that maybe half of the day it's set, but I'm having meetings. Sometimes it's so annoying because I need to do my work. I need to write code or discuss with the data engineers or analytical engineers some internal steps what they need to do, but I'm really busy with the clients or stakeholders or management gathering this. I actually prefer to just writing, creating, but when I'm getting the task, I need to be fully focused on the task. Yep. I can jump from different tasks because I need to renew my notes, what we have in the past, what I need to do, how, what's the possible solutions. So sometimes it's hard just to switch on the task, and context switching is brutal because sometimes I need maybe 1 hour to like renew my thoughts.
You need to be able to get into your groove. You gotta really think about things. Yeah, no, I get 100%.
As I am thinking that I am an analytical person.
How do you build consensus when there are different opinions?
As I said, I am preparing the pros and cons of my solution. And if another person have like some different point of view, I of course listening, and we are talking to each other as the amateur engineers and discussing what's the reasons why do you think it's probably better, what's the consequences of this solution. Sometimes who has the experience, and it's probably better to see the wider picture of the solution. I actually...
When was the last time you had your mind changed?
Did the mind change about my team in the better side? Because I'm realizing that people who is interesting in about the data or just general engineering, they are learning, they are trying to be better each day. And sometimes it's surprising for me that people in my team have the wider scope of interest and knowledge base, because I know the one of the data engineer who has skills with TypeScript and front-end developing, and it's really cool because he can understand our internal backend mm-hmm. and internal application engineering team. So it's really cool because these people are really valuable for the team.
What type of role do you find ideal for yourself?
Ideally, I would like to find the interesting scope, interesting line of the business where I can be performant and also keen on about the theme, right? Because I need to understand the internal kitchen. I need to understand internal processes to have a deep knowledge about the business and what's the profitable points for the business. And I need to be really, my mind should be as deeper ingestion into the business. And it's gonna be only with my real interest. So this company with the interesting tech stack, I noticed that I have my notes here. You are using DBT, Airflow, as I can see, and you also mentioned with some BI tools that you are using.
A set of questions from Nikita.
Yeah, I have a question about the tools. Are you using DBT Core inside Kubernetes or the cloud version? Do you know about the amount of the data and how fast it should be grow? What's the size? As you using Snowflake, you also don't know the costs, or data engineers are reporting to you? Do I need to work with this team, and do I
yes.
need to switch to GCP or... Because you are using AWS, so you preferably want to use their products. Which key metrics do you have? And yeah, just if you have answer, could you describe it?
What would you want to do if your time had been freed up?
I usually do my work on the workplace, nothing unrelated with the work. But if I have a time, I will probably invest in my personal education, touch some new technologies, new frameworks, maybe check. I'm usually checking the issues on the open source products.
Oh, nice.
Because it's also interesting for me how developers are supporting the products, and if it's too much issues and no one's created PRs for the open source solution, it could be like a science for me. What else? I'm buying some books. Recently, I bought a Snowflake book. My friend wrote this book and selling right now on Amazon. And what else? I'm taking a part in the data science society. And we are doing some education and workshops for new developers or existing data engineer developers. Taking some technologies, creating the workshops. It's online, but yeah, we're doing some education. It's totally free. It's really helpful to touch new technologies, have a better understanding in the technology, and also explain for the people who want to be in the data engineering. line of business.
How do you balance engineering possibilities with stakeholders' wishings?
It's a good question, and it's really common because, as you said, data engineering, it's not just engineering about the data. It's also about the infrastructure. How do you build your infrastructure? How do you prepare this infrastructure for the growing consistently amount of data, or sometimes with a peak amount of data? If something broke, you need to do, for example, backfill or something, because it's sometimes it's unpredictable. Personally, I think that it's really good when you building the good foundation in the beginning. You can predict the amount of data and how it will grow, for example, for next year, and you are prepared and you can add additional blocks to your infrastructure, and you can, for example, possibly say that, okay, we can adjust this, we can add more sources, we can process this without any failure, without any timeouts, without any airflow. But sometimes, yes, for example, the amount of data is really big, we need to compute power, and we can handle this data and prepare this. So we can, I usually do some PM backlog and do some grooming per sprint, and I can estimate the work to deliver for different engineers. And I can say, so we can build this in next 2-3 sprints, or we can defer it until we build the better foundation. It's always some compromises between business and our infrastructure, because business wants to know insights right now. As I understand from conversation, you are looking for the senior data engineer who will handle the whole infrastructure.
The final questions from Nikita.
How do you see this department for the next 1 or 2 years? Thank you for clarification.